गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. दिस वीक वी हैव कैपेसिटर्स एंड आरसी सर्किट्स. दैट वन, इफ यू लुक एट द कैपेसिटर्स हियर, द बिगेस्ट प्रॉब्लम फॉर यू इज लाइक कैपेसिटर नेटवर्क्स. ऑलमोस्ट मोस्ट ऑफ द थिंग्स यू नो इट, बट इवन देन सम 4, 5, 6 कैपेसिटर कम्स आउट टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट चार्ज. सो दैट इज नथिंग बट द ब्रांच करंट मेथड, वॉट वी स्टडीड इन दिस वन रेजिस्टर्स. नो how we divided the current in each branch. That particular method is what we'll be applying in this capacitor networks. So now what is the alternative? Because distribution of charge, if there are 2, 3 capacitors, okay, fine, very easy. But if you get a network, like some 10, 15 big circuits will come, no? Distribution of charge is highly inconvenient. We should go for definitely what happened, another alternative is best the nodal analysis. So possibility of asking any questions based on some networks also. So that's why I'm just trying to focus today on even some nodal analysis also. That one, charge distribution nodal analysis. What is the charge distribution method? Similar to that is the branch current method in the, but we don't go for K, like a loop current method here. Loop charge like that will not come, only the branch current method. That itself is what is called as here, like a charge distribution method. So any capacitor circuit comes. See, what I suggest is like the fear of finding out charge in all capacitors. Once you get on this, the rest all you can manage. You look at the advanced exams, no? They're asking simple questions. And you know, 2 capacitors, series, parallel, something questions related to that like this only. But possibility of asking some network-based questions. So once if you are strong with how to get a charge in all capacitors, no, the rest all everything conceptual questions like dielectric slab, if it is port, force acting, work done, all these other related problems will come. So today I'll focus more on finding out equivalent capacitance and charge on all capacitors of big circuits. So you'll get a confidence. Tomorrow we'll focus on dielectric slab and all other things. That one. Some heat generated also will take some few problems on heat generated. Okay, there's all switches are closed simultaneously. Find the heat generated in the circuit. I think if you look at the GE Advanced, especially, you know, the heat generated, I think he has asked some almost 9 times, huh? Different circuits will be there. I think previously some around 6 numericals I discussed. Now you can add one more. So like that, I brought another 3. I'll give few more. Practice that. It is nothing but again series parallel and branch current method. All together, one of the same. At a stretch, you can combine all the things. Okay, let's see what is the initial charge here. So the charge in this capacitor, I'll magnify it. Let me just magnify it. Yeah, okay. Now what is the initial charge here? Let it be Q naught minus Q naught. So what is Q naught is equal to Q naught is equal to 2 into 2, 4 coulomb. This is the initial charge in one of the capacitors. What about charge in other capacitors? 0. I'll close the switch. Then after closing the switch, we should bother about that initial charge or charge at an isolated junction. This is a circuit. We have 6 volt, 2 volt, and all these are 1 farad, 3 farad, and 2 farad. Now tell me, like, what you are going to do? Some charges are they series parallel? We don't know anything, so I'm going to go for charges like this: Q1 minus Q1. Q2 minus Q2, here Q3 minus Q3. And positive, negative. Plate will be positive, negative. Look at this particular junction. The moment you close switch, what will be the charge of this junction? So junction means here you try to bother. I'll shade it. We should bother about We have option of colors, no? So what should be the charge of these three plates? The moment I close switch, what is the charge at that point? It is plus Q naught. So charge of these three plates must be conserved, no? Able to understand this one. It's like a bucket idea again. The same idea of bucket capacitor means I said bucket, no, equivalent to buckets. The similar thing what you can apply here. Okay, now this is the, what is the charge of these three plates initially Q naught. Finally, what happened? It should be equal to Q naught here. Okay, now let's write shall I call isolated junction? What do you mean by isolated? Because there is no any other cell is connected here. So definitely you can call this as isolated junction. At isolated conservation of charge. Junction G. So what was initial charge? It was like a Q naught. Final charge, it should be Q3 minus Q1 plus Q2. Okay, how to find out that? Apply KVL. But sir, like a charge again should be conserved. Okay, now again, what is the charge of a cell should be conserved? What charge left the positive terminal of cell 6 volt? The same positive charge should enter here. Like that, we should cross check for that conservation of charge later on. Whether we are right or wrong, the charge of a cell should be conserved. There's a charge at isolated junction. So let's write loop equation now. This will be plus 6 minus Q1 by 1 minus Q2 by 3 minus 2 equal to 0. Or this 4 is equal to Q1 minus Q2. Let me write one more equation. Plus 6 minus Q1 by 1 minus Q3 by 2 equal to 0. I'm tracing the loop like this. Plus 6 minus Q1 by 1 minus Q3 by 2 equal to 0. Okay, this will be 6 is equal to Q1. This is positive, no? One more we needed. So plus 2 plus Q2 by 3 minus Q3 by 2 equal to 0. So this should be equal to 2 equal to Q3 by 2 minus Q2 by 3. Solving 1, 2, 3, we'll get the thing. So he is asking each generator. I think we must know the charges Q1, Q2. Then only I can do something in the problem. Anybody? Q1, Q2, Q3?
Q1 10 by 3,
Q2 2,
Q3 16 by 3.
Wait. So slowly. Q1 10 by 3.
Q2 2, Q3 16 by 3.
All are positive, huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now you have to ask one best question to teacher. Sir, how do you can say this is a positive unit? I too don't know, to be frank. I just assume. Sir, I'll assume minus Q1 plus Q1. Okay, solve it. If you get negative, change the polarity. Change the polarity. That's the only alternative available for us. Okay, now what was earlier? What was the charge of this plate? Okay, now come for this plate. I'm giving green color to this plate here. Look at the green color plate. What was the earlier charge? Similar to like a bucket. So what was the charge here? Zero. Now finally, what was the charge Q1? So what charge has flown here? Q1 charge should flow here. So we'll give some flow like this. Let it. You have to trace out a charge. For that, I'll take help of positive plate of any one capacitor. Okay, this capacitor C1. So what was earlier? So zero plus QA and it has become Q1. So we know Q1. So therefore, what is QA equal to? So that same QA should flow here also. No, let's come for this one. What was the earlier charge of this plate? what was that, zero. Now it has become minus Q2. So what do you expect? Some positive charge has flown like this. So that charge flown, let me bring like this here. Sir, how come you are saying, okay, why don't you put QB? It's left to you, anything that one. I'm taking here entered, I took positive. Intentionally, I'm taking the charge left. The charge left here. Okay, let's do one thing. For the green color plate, this is. No, brown color plate. Brown color plate. What was earlier charge? Zero. Some charge left. Charge left means you should take negative. And finally, how much of charge? Q2. So therefore, what is QB equal to? 2 coulomb. Okay, try to see this symbol. I would have taken QB positive, but I wanted to make students to learn. If a charge leaves a plate, it should be negative. If a charge enters, it should be positive. Convention, I'll okay, now I think why positive, why negative? Charge left negative, charge entered positive. So QB, I got it. Now QB, how do it will enter? QB will pass. Okay, now let's look at the Q3. What was the earlier charge of any plate? You take the lower plate, this one. What was the charge of this? Yeah, there's a red color plate. You can pick up anyone. It's left to you. I'm just picking up this one. Or no, sir, I'll take positive plate. Okay, it's left to you. So anyone, let me choose this one. Now look at the red color plate here. For red color plate, what was the earlier charge? Minus Q naught. And finally, it has become minus Q naught is 4 coulomb and it has become 16/3. 16/3, definitely the value is 5. So I'll assume that some charge entered. So plus QC and it has become minus Q3. Q naught was how much? Minus 4. Minus 16/3. So QC should be equal to minus 4/3 coulomb. What do you mean by negative? Some charge left here. Again, for me, let me do one thing. I'll assume charge left only. Because in the final, I do. Okay, this will be negative. Okay, I think it's justified, no? So what is the charge at this junction? QA is how much? QA is 10/3. Then QC plus QB add up. So anyway, the charge must be considered. What charge entered here, that much should leave. And what charge entered positive, that much should leave. Like that, Walpen, what all, if you go wrong anywhere in mathematics, no, definitely everything here, QC plus QB will not be equal to QA. And what charge entered, that much should leave. So like that, Walpen, everything will get disturbed here. So therefore, definitely, Walpen, somewhere, like when you are ending up the problem, check like a conservation of charge at a junction. If it is valid, okay, then your mathematics is correct. Okay, after getting all this, okay, now I think, shall we go for heat generated? Because they will help us to check whether this one. What this battery? Positive charge leaves positive terminal. Then battery should do positive work. If positive charge enters positive terminal, battery does negative work. Now tell me like what shall I do for heat generated? Any formula for heat generated? Initial energy plus work done by, okay, this is cell one, cell two, W1, work done by it. W2 final energy plus E. I think in every numerical, what will be the numerical? Whether some spring is there, some any piston is there, what will be the circumstance? Let's not bother. This will be the generalized formula everywhere. If like a work done by external agent will come, okay, that work by external agent, okay, let it be. See, I can also, in this problem also, I can pull this plate. I'll be doing work. You know, this one. So that you are going to bring it, work done by external agent, work done by the cell. This is a generalized formula. Please carry on in all every numerical, irrespective of numerical, whether spring force, friction, axial force is there, tension, any other agent does work here. So that has to be included here. So I think if you look at the electromagnetism, then I think, yes, just say that if action agent also is involved in doing work in the system, that has to be substituted here. He has made it really very beautiful. Again, don't read it. No use. Just this information was there. I just wanted to share you that one. Of course, we don't do any problem. Okay, that one in advance, they may ask you. So work done by action agent in pulling this plate from D to 2D. So that you include here. Okay, now initial energy. So Q naught squared by 2C4 plus work done by the cell. QA into 6. Then this cell will do negative work. QB into 2. Final potential energy. Q1 square by 2C1. Q2 square by 2C2. Solve for this, you'll get the heat generated. I think I did the same problem in the book where this capacitor was not there. I just brought one this capacitor, and that too with initial charge. Earlier in regular class, we had a problem where this capacitor was not there. With this capacitor charge, let it be. You can manage. Now, sir, what about charge flow here? Yes, you can take help of this one. What was earlier charge? Minus Q1. So some charge should leave here. So you can trace it. Same QA charge will come. Your QB charge. Your QC. Anybody having doubt, you can just ask me. There's a very popular problem. Same thing I think we did in regular class without this capacitor and initial charge. Now with capacitor and initial charge, I brought it. I'll scroll down. Solve it later on. Solve for H.
20/3.
H equal to this much?
Yes, sir.
Okay, somebody verify it. Okay, now we'll go for the next one. See, that's all. You should get a confidence, like a resistor. No, any network given, how to find out equivalent resistance. The similar idea is what a student must have. Okay, now find the heat generated after switch S is closed. Before closing switch, we should know the charges in all the capacitors. This will be the charge, say Q1 minus Q1, Q2 minus Q2. Small letters, let me take it. No. So what is Q1? Q1 we know. Q1 we can tell very easily. This is before closing switch, with the S open. With the switch S open, we are discussing the problem. Let's get into the thing now. So Q1 should be equal to 2 into 4, 8. 8 coulombs. What about Q2? So total how much will be 1 farad? Q2 should be equal to 1 into 4, 4 coulomb. How do, let me have water. Somebody yesterday, just we had a discussion with my friends, that one. So what is the impact of this COVID on the students? That one. So I thought initially my students are suffering, but I analyzed it. It's like an advantage for you. On your own, you're analyzing. I think teacher is just coming, teaching, and one or two doubts you're asking. But the maximum you are putting your own effort, I think this will really going to help you a lot. Rather than depending on totally on teacher, no, you are trying to become independent. Just you are taking some help from teacher through online classes, then remaining whatever you are fighting on your own, analyzing, comparing that problem from that textbook, how answer has come. I think this is what needed in science. Science is not like something where teacher will teach all the numerical, then you'll give assignment, then you'll teach all questions and assignment, then paper, you'll teach all, then something related to that will come in exam, then you'll get good rank. Okay, fine, you get a good rank. But what about knowledge? So we had a discussion with one of my old friends from Bangalore. So that's what they're telling, like most of them, not only for you, even in school also, students are trying to learn on their own. And this is what the basic necessity of science. So even if you're getting a little bit less marks, no, but you are growing on your own. I think this will have a very high impact on your the future job. That one means independent thinking. What happened? You are slowly developed. Now you are not dependent on anybody. You are gathering information from teacher and trying to apply it on your own. So take this as a positive one, not negative. That one. So too much dependent on teacher. No, that was very harmful for students actually. But here, what happened? Things are a little bit. You are in better position. You are comparing because you are not getting, no, you are comparing from other book. So I think this is what needed in science, to be frank. So if a teacher helps you maximum 90%, no, then only 10% your effort. But I think the students who are asking doubt also, they're asking some very good questions, not like some earlier thing, that one. Yes, most of you are posting very good doubts. So this shows that you're really putting effort. Take this as inspiration, positive that you are on right path. Further, you have to improve. This is the thing. Okay, why I wrote Q2 suddenly? Because all these capacitors are series. Then will be 1/3 plus 1/3, 1/3. Effective capacitance of this will be how much? Will be 1 farad. Finding difficult, okay, do one thing. Show like this. What is this 1 farad? This 1 farad is this one. Huh? So therein, so don't go for again, sir. I'll replace these two. Then I'll find out charge. Then distribution of charge directly. What is the potential here? 4 volt, 4 volt. We'll get this one. So this is a charge. What we got? Now I'm going to close the switch. So now the switch is going to be closed. Little bit, you have to be alert. Now, what to do with the capacitor, which is where I'm going to close the switch. This will be as it is, 3 farad, 3 farad. Here is what I'm going to close the switch. Now, what shall I do with this capacitor? It's a shorted, no? You can replace with a short circuit wire. So what happened to charge here? Charge, where do it go? This charge, will it go here? No, this charge Q3 will go like this. And 0 and 0. So there won't be any charge in this capacitor. No charge. That Q3 will flow like this. So we are not, okay, leave it, not needed. So I'm just putting this one. This plus Q will go in and will come here. Finish all. So you may ask you what charge flown through the switch Q3. Okay, let's come for now. Now we have only these two capacitors. Again, now they are like a parallel. No? So 3 farad, 3/2 will come here. So what is the charge in them? Q1 minus Q1, Q2 minus Q2. So Q1 should be as usual. So there won't be change in that. Q1 should be equal to, I'll find, write down here. Q1 should be equal to 2 into 4, 8 coulomb. What about Q2? 1.5 coulomb. How much it will be? 6 coulomb. No? Yeah. So Q2, so 4 volt, it will drop 2 volt. No. So Q2 should be 3 into 2. 6 coulombs will be there. So what is the initial energy in the circuit? So now, what about the heat? Any charge will flow through the circuit. So there is no charge flow through this bench. No? What was the charge of this capacitor? Plus Q1, plus Q1. And small Q1 equal to capital Q1. No charge will flow here. Will there be any flow of charge? Okay, let's take this particular branch. What was the earlier charge? 4 coulomb. Now how much it is? 6 coulomb is there. So some 2 coulomb charge should have entered. So I'll put it Q0. Take help of this one plate. That will be sufficient to trace out the charge. Green color plate. No, green color plate. What was the earlier charge? Q2. Some Q0 charge entered and it has become Q2. Q2 is 8. Q0 and this is 6. 2 coulomb charge and no charge flows here.
Q2 force. Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay, Q0 here. So that Q0, what happened? I should trace out like this. What is the total charge flown through the switch? Anybody wants to answer? Q0 or Q0 plus Q3?
Q0.
This Q3 charge, Q3 charge and Q0 both should flow, no?
The switch is Q0 plus Q3.
Through the switch will be Q0 plus Q3. Here only Q0. Okay, that one. So be alert. Anything they can ask you here. Okay, what is the work done by cell? Positive. So initial energy, again, the same formula, plus work done by cell equal to UF plus UH. Initial energy in the circuit will be Q1 square by 2 into 3. Q2 square, no? Q1 square into 2 into 2 plus work done by cell 4 into Q0. Final energy in the circuit, Q2 square, this is 3 times, 2 times of Q2 square by 2 into 3 plus, substitute all this, all, you'll get H, heat generated.
Well,
how much?
12.
Sir, I got 4, sir.
Even I don't know.
Sir.
4, huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay, fine. Just check the answer. Charge flown through the switch will be Q0 plus Q3. That comment also if you want to write. Charge. No, there is no cell here. This is something very important. Let me magnify it. I just picked up randomly, so that general idea will come. I think if you can recollect, we did one problem from Pathfinder without any cell. The same, let it be this one. Previous problem, you check it, there were cells. No. There's no cell in the circuit. Then also heat generated, is it possible? Where do these ideas from where these ideas has come. So if you can recollect some questions, what we did, like one charger plate connected to another uncharged plate, this one. So here I brought some sort of like a circuit here. So I'll just make you to recollect some, if you can remember. Okay, now what is the method like? So some small ideas, let me share, like already we have discussed. So this is like this, no? Now you see this. This was having a charge. Okay, this is say like a 10 volt, 2 farad, this is a 4 farad. I'll close the switch. Then after closing switch, what do we get? The charge here will be Q1, Q2, minus Q1, Q2. Can you remember some questions like this? This is 2 farad, this is 4 farad. What was earlier charge? Q0 minus Q0. Now, charge of these two plates must be conserved. Charge of these two plates must be conserved. Or you can you can pick up any pair of plates. So what was the charge? So same thing like what we discussed, Q0 equal to Q1 plus Q2. You see now here. It'll be like this. Then what is the next thing left? Loop equation. So always don't remember that potential is same. See, I may bring a situation where there'll not be series parallel. So what I suggest, go for loop equation, Q1 by 2. Let me do this. Q1 by 2 minus Q2 by 4 equal to 0. Look at now, Q1, Q2 are unknown. You calculate. So what was the initial energy of circuit UI plus, is there any cell? There's no cell. Okay, leave it. Put work done by cell, UF plus H. There's no cell. Even if cell is there, if it doesn't do work, okay, put 0. So UI, we know Q0 square by 2 into 2 plus 0. UF is what? Q1 square by 2 into 2. Q2 square is 2 into 4 plus heat generated. The universal formula, I'm just saying that one. You see the total capacitors, whether resistor is there, whatever the element, no? So you can bring this into the picture. If any work dump exigent, bring that work dump exigent here. It should not be an RHL. Once again, I'm reminding it. Now, even sir, this also charged. Okay, that initial charge, you bring it. Some initial charge here. If one more capacitor is there, okay, let it be. So conservation of charge of a plate, then loop equation. So don't say potential equal. Yes, it's correct. In fact, to be say the potential equal. Two capacitors there, we say potential equal, but always trust on loop equation. Go round, write KVL or. No, apply that idea here. So what was the earlier charge of the system? Here it was Q0 minus Q0. So first we'll calculate Q0. Q0 will be 2 into C5. This will be 10 farad. Now I'm going to close the switch.
Q5 is 2 farad.
Q5 is how much?
C5 is 2 farad, sir. Q0 will be 4 coulomb.
Okay, 2 farad, no? 2 into 2, 4 coulomb, yeah. And now the next part of the circuit will be this is the thing. So what about the charge, how to distribute charge? Here is a problem arises. Okay, I'll start like this. Q1 minus Q1, Q2, Q3. Q2. Let this be Q3. let's assume that there's a charge in all capacitors and the final charge, this will be Q phi minus Q phi. This is C phi. I think there's the only thing which is available for us. No charge of which plates, so charge of these plates should be conserved. You have, I think, many things, not only this. And similarly, charge of this plate. So you can even go for charge of these two plates should be conserved. Similarly, charge of these three plates should be conserved. And you can also fine. This is a thing. How many unknowns are there? Just look at once. Five unknowns. Okay, let's see how we'll get this five unknowns. Loop equations. Anyway, we can write loop equation. Then conservation of charge principle. It's very easier. Don't bother. Like, say, five unknowns. What to do? Okay, let's do one thing. Red color plates. We'll look at what was the charge on the red color plates. So earlier, I think the red color plate. I have to show it here. Look at only that color sign and write the equation. What was the earlier charge of red color plate at red color plate? There's the initial part. There's the thing. Red at red color plates. For red color, what is the equation I can write? Earlier charge was 0 plus 0. Finally, minus Q1 plus Q3. So therefore, Q1 equal to Q3. Then blue color plates will take it. Blue color plates. So what was the charge? 0 plus 0 minus Q2. And anything, I'll make it positive negative. That will be, it will be easy for us. Minus Q2 plus Q4. So Q2 equal to Q4. This is the thing. Okay, next, let me go for yellow color plates. What was the earlier charge? Q naught. Q naught plus 0 plus 0. And finally, it has become Q5 plus Q1 plus Q2. Q naught value we know, 4. So 4 equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q5. Then what is this color? Anybody? Name of this color? Hasha, this is gray color. I'll write it. Gray color plates. What was the earlier charge? Minus Q naught plus 0 plus 0 is equal to minus of Q5 minus Q4 minus Q3. This is again equal to 4 only. 4 equal to Q3 plus. Okay, solve this. So these are the equations 1, 2, 3, 4. So we'll write one loop equation. We'll write one loop equation and we'll get the required answer. So loop equation. Next, we'll write the loop equation. So loop equations will be, I'll start with Q1 by C1 minus Q2 by C2 minus Q4 by C4 You want to bring also Q5 if you want. You can write one more equation with any number. You can write it. Q phi by C phi. I think this will be sufficient. We can solve them. Solving all this, we'll get it. Then what will happen? We can go for each generator. What is each generator? Again, UI plus UF equal to H. UI is Q naught square by 2C phi. See, if you can just get a clarity, the methodology you have to understand, finish over. You can manage most of the numericals here with cell, without cell. The idea is same. What we should do, we should trace out the charge. If cell is there, we should trace out the charge in a branch where cell is connected. If there is no cell is there, then there won't be any problem for us. And charge at isolated junction must be conserved. It's a very random, so all these ideas, like a charge at isolated junction is conserved, charge of a cell should be conserved. Then work done by the cell. For that, you should know in the branch in which where cell is connected. Do calculation later on. Let me go for the next one.
100 by 49.
Okay, nice, good. Yeah, 100 by?
49.
Yeah, thank you. Previously, I think we had discussed some problems. You recollect that and questions can be of this one. Okay, next we'll go to some nodal analysis method because I had to make you perfect in that one. Okay, this, if you want, you can bring nodal analysis or chart distribution, we'll see once. We'll take problem like that. So this is the circuit we have, is asking to find out the potential difference VAB. Means we should know the charge in the capacitor 3 farad after closing the switches. Initial, there is no charge in the capacitor. Questions can be after. This is solvable within 3-4 minutes. we can solve it. Don't go for just what method you can bring it. Shall we go for a charge distribution? Okay, let's see that. Let's focus on charge distribution. Q1 minus Q1, Q2 minus Q2, then Q3 minus Q3, Q4. Okay, this one. Shall I put charge QA minus QA, QB cube minus QB, QB and minus QB, and no charge flows here? There's a really good problem where students are made to learn how to distribute charges. I'll assume this one. If you say I agree, then I'll write loop equation, then we'll get answer. Actually, we should learn first what? The capacitors, then we should come to resistors. That's actually the scientific order. I don't know, in India, we are changed that order itself. Because see, once students learn the flow of charge, then the meaning of resistors branch current will be very easier. So since when you learn KVL, nodal analysis, come here and apply, the charge distribution method, you will not be strong. Anyway, like already, we manipulated so many things. Okay, let's adjust ourselves. Is it okay now? Charge of SL, how much of charge will leave here? QA plus QB. QA plus QB, fine. Okay, we'll write loop equation. Okay, anyway, these two are series. We'll agree, this is wrong. Sir, where is it wrong? Everything is fine. See, everything is fine. Conservation of charge, sir, how much of charge? QA plus QB. QA plus QB has entered. What about here? This battery also does work, no? But sir, like I distributed charge, this is what happens here. So we are not very sure like what will be the charge in these two will be same, need not. If you remove this cell, okay, fine. So if this cell were not there, okay, no, correct. There's no problem. getting the idea? Because of cell present, it should not happen. Getting the idea? So this will be the wrong. So what shall we do now? Okay, we'll go for chart distribution. It's a nice problem for learning purpose. Q1 minus Q1. Okay, this will be Q2, we'll take it. This will be, okay, we'll write it. Q3 minus Q3, Q4 minus Q4. Okay, how many unknowns are there? 4 unknowns. What about the isolated junction? So the charge of these 4 plates must be conserved. Look at this one now. What was the earlier charge of these 4 plates? Look at, sir, but there is a cell is also there. Let it be, no problem. What to do with cell? Net charge of cell should be 0. Cell, let it be wherever. How much of charge enters positive terminal, that much of charge should leave negative terminal. So let's not bother about that cell. Okay, there'll be exchange. So here, charge of this yellow color plates must be conserved. What was the earlier charge? 0, because initially no charge across capacitors. Okay, I'll take out this one. No, charge of. Charge of yellow color plates must be conserved. No. What was earlier charge? 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0 equal to minus Q1, minus Q2, minus Q3, minus Q4. So therefore, Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4 equal to 0. Right loop equation. 22 volt loop equation, sir. No, 22 minus Q2 by 8 minus Q3 by 10 equal to 0. Then 22 minus Q1 by 3 minus Q4 by 4 equal to 0. One more, we can also do like this. Q1 by 3 minus Q2 by 8. Plus 6 equals 0. So what is this? The path like this. Q plus, if I move from negative to positive, plus rise in drop. Plus Q1 by 3 minus Q2 by 8 plus 6 equal to 0. This is the path. So one more. Okay, we'll write here. Plus 6 minus Q4 by 4. I think so many equations are there. Solving will get the required answer. I have Q1, 24 coulombs. I have only the some data is there. And VAB and VAB is 8 volt. Check it once. You do later on, calculations, everything. I think you should not take risk of fighting charge distribution. Sir, why can't these two be same charge? So you can't say, that's why you solve this question. Definitely you are going to get all these 4 charges are different. So this shows that. And there is some charge distribution. You have to be very careful. On our own, we can't assume straight away like. Okay. Some problem is there. Wait. This will be plus. Please do notice, actually, negative plate, positive plate, negative plate, positive plate. Okay, this should become equal to. Not negative, positive charge, no. Minus Q1, minus Q2, plus Q3, plus Q4. Can be asked in advance, simple idea based. No, slowly, I think I'm just increasing the level of problems. Charge of a cell should be concerned. That's a core idea here. What charge leaves positive terminal here of battery? That much of charge should enter here. So definitely the cell will push a charge here, Q1 and Q2. Some charge will also flow here. No, sir, I'll remove this capacitor. You can't do like that. Huh? Sir, I'll remove these two capacitors, then same charge will flow. You can't remove on your own. At least don't do that mistake here. Now the charge distribution will take it. Let's come for this one here. So I'll assume a charge Q1. Q2 minus Q2. So let this be Q3 minus Q3. So how much of charge here will be Q2 plus Q3? Here Q1 minus Q3. I'll show charge only on positive plate. Then again, Q1. So minus Q3 plus Q3. Try to make observation of charge distribution. Definitely what you see, you are a teacher, okay, you're distributing. What about student? This is a primary question what student they ask. Okay, sir, you are a teacher, expertise, okay, somehow past 20 years you're teaching. Okay, that's why you got a method. How do I come to know? For you also, what happened? Practice 5-6 problems, then get method. There's no any formula. Like you can't say like, sir, tell anyone formula, distribute charge. Numerical to numerical things will change. Only charge of a cell should be considered. Charge at isolated junction should be zero. How many isolated junctions are there? A, B, E, F isolated junctions are there. What is earlier charge? Zero. Now also you check the charge minus Q1 plus Q1 plus Q3 minus Q3. Charge of these two. These three plates earlier zero, now also should be zero. So what are the golden rules you have to follow? Charge of a cell will be considered what charge left positive terminal, that much charge should enter negative terminal. Charge at isolated junction should be zero. I think these are the only things which will help you. Series, parallel ideas. They're not series nor parallel. So I went for distribution. Now Q1, Q2, I assumed it. Here some Q3 charge will go. So Q1 charge will come here. So Q3 will go. Remaining Q1 minus Q3 will come here. Now Q3 charge entered, then induced charge minus Q plus Q3 from here, plus Q3 plus Q2 will become Q2 plus Q3. Then here Q2 plus Q3 will come. Q3 will go here, then Q2. Sir, why not here Q3? Why not here Q2? I think charge should be conserved. No? What charge left positive, that much should enter negative terminal. For that, keeping that in mind, I'm distributing here. Okay, how many unknowns are there? Q1, Q2, Q3. Solving this, we'll get the required answer. okay, first 23 volt. Let me write loop equation. 23 minus Q1 by 15 minus Q3 by 5 minus so we'll get one equation here. Similarly, 23 minus Q2 by 5 one more loop equation, loop A E F B Q1 minus Q3 by 5 and this will be negative, no? I'll move from positive to negative plate, then plus Q3 by 0.75 plus Q2 plus Q3 by 15 plus Q3 by 0.75. Now, what is the loop? There's a loop. Minus Q1 minus Q3 by 5. Why negative? I'm moving from positive to negative plate. Look at this, if you write like this. From fall in drop, minus of Q1 minus Q3 by 5 plus Q3 by 0.75. Q2 plus Q3 by 15, then plus Q3 by 0.75. I think three equations, three are no solving, will get Q1, Q2, Q3. VAB will be 5 volt. Check the answers. Let on your work out. I think definitely VEF will be negative.
Q3 15 by 4, sir.
I don't know. I don't have in between values. No question answer is there. VAB will be 5 volt is given. Shall I go for next one? Do calculation later on. So I think we are facing some big problem with what? Chart distribution, no? So let's see alternative methods. So as the size of circuit increases, I think chart distribution method also not advisable. Then what is advisable? The advisable thing is we'll go for the nodal analysis. Nodal analysis can also be applied here. It's quite very, very easy for you with the nodal analysis. For any circuit, you can draw it. Chart distribution only for limited, some sort of thing that one. So I'm going to begin with a simple problem. We can solve this by chart distribution. Instead, I'm showing this one. So let this be 0 volt. You can pick up anything. So let me... The old, let me define like this here. Then this is 10 plus X. Let this be X. Then this should also be 10 plus X. Then what should be the potential? This should be 20 volt because the potential difference across a cell. Who is going to help you to define potential? The cell. The drop across a cell should be called its potential difference. Keeping that in mind, we define potentials at the various junctions. Then this should also be X. Then afterwards, charge of a cell should be conserved, no? So there are, so what we have, these plates. I'm putting a yellow color shade. So charge of these three plates should be conserved, but there's a cell in between. I think still it should be conserved, no? Okay, writing nodal equation at this particular point will get the required answer. but we don't know charge. That's what we should try to write the nodal equation. A charge of this three plates should be conserved. No, what was the initial charge? Zero. Or you, if you want, you can go for these plates. Anything. How many unknowns are there? Only x is unknown. Somehow you should bring that equation for x. Problem will be solved. Sir, even charge is not considered. Also, you can avoid. You can go for. Okay, x is there. No, I should bring x here. I'll do one thing. I will shade yellow different. Let it be this one. Now look at this. Nodal analysis, you're going to apply it. So don't distribute any charge, leave it. Don't bother surcharge here, Q1, Q2, Q3, nothing to do. Just come for at node X. Okay, there's some point will indicate. P at node P, directly jump into the problem. At node P. Charge of that should be equal to zero, no? If there were any initial charge, bring that initial charge also. That's the only thing. So charge of this should be conserved. So x minus zero into four. So how you define charge? Capacitance into potential difference. So first thing is like x minus zero into four. Q equal to C potential difference, or say like four into potential, capacitance into potential difference plus this will be capacitance, how much? 2 into x minus 20 plus this should be 10 plus x potential capacitance is 2, 10 plus x equal to 0. Try to all set equal to zero. Why zero? Because initially there is no charge in that system. So I think this will be very useful for you. I'm telling this one. We'll get answer. You see this one. No, this will be 4x plus 2x minus 40 plus 20 plus 2x equals zero. Anybody value of x?
Two point five volt.
Once you know x, you can easily tell no what is the charge capacitance in each and every capacitor. Like this, how many nodes are there? Those many nodal equations will come. Those many unknowns will be there. So once you know x, now you know x equal 2.5. So you can calculate the charge. You know 10 plus x value, this zero. You know the charge. You know x and you know this 20. You get the potential difference and you will get the charge here. Now biggest problem for you, sir. There is a battery is there. You need to bother. The charge of these plates are conserved. So charge of this Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 equal to zero. What is Q1? Potential difference into capacitance. That we write directly here. Because what teachers should teach here, teachers should not write anything Q1, Q2, Q3. The moment if I say that write Q1, Q2, Q3, again, biggest problem for distribution of charge, no? So no need to indicate even charges also. Please make a practice. Maybe you may find initial difficult, later on you find very convenient. I need not to bother what charges, positive plate, negative plate, is this positive, is it negative? I need not to bother. Just like, what is the charge here? Potential difference into capacitance. So charge of these plates are conserved. So we can also solve by this what, like charge Q1, here Q2, here how much, so like here charge Q2, so like a Q2 will come Q1, Q1 plus Q2 here. We can solve this. If you want, I'll show it. So definitely you will thank me that, okay, sir, teaching very good method. Thank you very much. Your comment should be like this. 20 volt, this is 10 volt. This is 2 farad, this is 2 farad, this 4 farad. So what is the charge distribution? I'll put like this, Q1 minus Q1. Here, or if you want to write Q2 minus Q2, Q3 minus Q3. Then charge of a, what should be the conservation of charge principle? Charge of a plates, Q minus Q1 plus Q3 plus Q2 should be zero. Or since I took it, let me go for this one. Okay, fine. Q1, Q3, Q2, charge of this. What is Q1? Potential difference into capacitance. What is Q3? Potential difference into capacitance. What is Q2? Potential difference capacitance. So instead of giving charges, writing this conversion of charge, then finding Q1, Q2, Q3 directly. This is not advisable. Not advisable means don't forget. When you have nodal analysis, this is not needed to think. Why? Means distribution of charge will be very difficult. Distribution of charge in bigger networks will be very difficult. So this is a small circuit. Okay, now as I proceed, you can see that one. Even your teacher is scared to distribute charges. He'll prefer nodal analysis. Anything. Okay, no. To be frank, even for me also, it take time if I go for distribution of charge. I'm asking you to find potential x, x and y. So there's a potential zero t as defined. I'll proceed like this. Okay, this circuit very big. Potential x and y, that is what needed, no? So I'll define the potentials, no? Just put round like this, huh? And this is 0 volt. This should be 20. Potential difference. So this is 20 means this should be 10 volt. I'm taking help of a cell. Okay, then we have here 20 volt is there. So therefore this should be minus 10. I'm taking help of cell. Who will help us to define these potentials? The cells. I started from here. This is y already has given. So y. Okay, I don't know what is the value of y. Then what is the potential difference? 20 volts. So this is y, 20 plus y. Potential difference is 20 volts. So 20 minus 0. This potential difference is 10 volts. Already I took 20. So this should be 10. 20 minus 10, this will be 10. This potential difference is 20 volts. This already I defined 10. So therefore minus 10. 10 minus of minus 10, 20. And this should be 20. So here this will be already this I defined x. So what is the alternative now? X plus 20, I think. Now, where you are going to look at? Isolated junction. So isolated junction is here. How many capacitors are there? 4 capacitors are there. So 4 potential drops, you are going to write it. Okay, this everything we'll call, this is like a node. Yellow color node and blue color node. And this also. Okay, we'll write the equation now. Yellow color node. just a practice. It's a skill. I'm telling you, it's not a concept. It's a skill. The moment you practice and understand, finish over. there's no any concept involved here. It's a skill that will come by practice. Okay, now how to write? Four capacitors are there, no? Okay, let me begin with. So from here, like, you know, what is the potential charge of that should be considered? So potential difference 20y minus 10. Minus 10 into 5. So capacitance. So we write potential difference Q equal to C into V. 5 into 20 plus y minus of minus 10 plus. This will be 10 farad, 20 plus y minus 20 plus. This will be 10 farad y minus 20 plus 5 farad y minus 0. All set equals 0 because initially there was no charge. There was no charge here. If any, so no, you can ask question, sir. This is having some charge. You are going to bring that in RHS here. Nobody will ask you, but will be very okay. But charge distribution you can't do. So even don't ask me, sir. Distribute charge, please. I had to really put easily one hour. I should sit, or at least half an hour. I should sit and they should distribute charge. Charge of a cell should be considered. Charge of a junction should be considered. Node analysis is a method. Okay, let's simplify this. This will be 5 into 30 plus y. So this will be 10y. This will be 0. Similarly, we'll go for blue color node. At blue color node. Then x minus x minus of minus 10 into capacitance, how much? It is 10 plus x minus 5. X plus 20 minus 10. This is 10. This will be 5 into equal to 0. So this will be 10 into x plus 10, 5 into x minus 10. This will be 10 into x plus 10. Solving 1 into, we'll get x and y. Once you get x and y, rest everything you can calculate. If you know x, you'll get the charge here. If you know x, you'll get the charge here. Okay, this one. If you know x, you'll get the charge here. If you know y, oh no, problem. Anybody value?
X is and equal y? To minus 25 by 3, y is equal to 5 by 3.
Y equal to minus or plus?
Plus 5 by 3.
There's a universal, it's like a, even there is series, parallel, anywhere, not like something big circuit. For any network, this is applicable. See, now you need not to bother distribution of charge. Only thing is, if initial charge is there, let it be. Even initial charge, you are going to include it here. Fine? Even if there is an initial charge in this capacitor, okay, that you are going to include it here in RHS and carry on the problem. This already we have done. Once again, I bring it. Let's not do by distribution of charge method. I'm asking you to find out CAB, effective capacitance. So what is the method I do is like, I know I have to find out only effective capacitance. So to make the problem very simple, this is a very important one. It's not a Wheatstone network. You can see now, ratio of 3/2 is not equal to 1/4. Here I'll connect a cell. Say even if you can connect a cell of 2 volt also, it's left to you. So this will be how much potential now? 10 volt, and this will be 0 volt. Then potential of this be X, this is Y. Now I'll find out the effective charge that has flown. Then once you know potential and charge, can you calculate the capacitance? Yes, we'll get capacitance. So first write, we'll get X and Y. Then I'll take help of this yellow color note. It a local node X minus, this will be try to follow 3 × X − 10, then 2 × X − 0 plus 5 × X − Y = 0. Then next blue color one. Blue color one, so y minus 10. What is the capacitance? 1. Y minus 4 × Y − 0, y minus x, 5 × Y − 6. Two equations to unknown, solve that, you'll get x and once you know x and y, you'll get the charge in all the capacitors. After getting the charge, so that battery only will push that charge, no? The same thing, I'll further continue. So here Q1, Q2. Don't distribute charge again. In exam, it will kill your time. Let's not go for further. How much of charge here? Q1 plus Q2. So what is the effective capacitance CAB? CAB should be equal to Q1 plus Q2 by 10. So how to calculate Q1, Q2? Yes, we have. So what is Q1? Q1 equal to 10 minus 3 into 10 minus X. What is Q2? 1 into 10 minus Y. So from the equations 1 and 2, you're going to calculate X and Y. That you substitute, get Q1, Q2. Substitute, you'll get CAB.
34/15
CAB. It's not a Wheatstone network. You can see that one. The ratio of these two arms is not equal to this. See, the charge distribution method, we are trying to, when a big network comes or even any network, even any network, you can go for charge distribution. Now let me make you familiar with. Yeah. Find charge on all capacitors. I forgot to give the question. Find the charge on all capacitors. No, you can see this. Shall we go for the same nodal analysis? Charge distribution, if you want to try it. Sir, I'll distribute the charge. Definitely we have to spend a time. Nodal analysis doesn't need anything. No effort, nothing directly. We should define the potentials. So how to define the potentials now? So let's do one thing. Potential, I'll take help of the battery. This is having potential. I'll define this as 0 volt. Then this should be 20 volt. Let me magnify diagram. So this should be 20 volt means how much this should be? This should be 40 volt. If this is 0 volt, then if this is 0 volt, then this should be 10 volt. Only unknown thing, X and Y, finish volt. Then I'll get a. So who are the best friends in nodal analysis? The battery, no? The cell is a best friend, which will help you to write. So at yellow node, yellow actually junction you have to call it, yellow node or junction, anything. Write it here now, x minus 10 2 into x minus 10, 4 into x minus y, plus 4 into x minus 0. Then similarly at blue node or junction, y minus x, 4 into y minus x, y minus 40, 4 x and y are unknown, solve it, you'll get remaining all the charges. Charge distribution, you try to think charge distribution. This will send a charge Q1, minus Q1. Here you're going to put Q2, then Q3. Then Q1 charge has come. Then the Q1, you have to send it back. This will be really very troublesome, even for me also, to be frank. So actually you have to divide, division of charge itself will take more time. So in meanwhile, what happened? Within 1-2 minutes, you can solve this question, nodal analysis. Luckily, if an exam comes, I think nodal analysis is the preferable method. That's what I suggest. Anybody, X and Y, both 100 by 3? Check the value, we are getting this much. I'll take the next one. Look at, no. So we have to define the potential. So what is the best thing we can start here, no? I will zero volt, I'll call this. This will be x plus 10, let this be x. You can use any method. Don't think that what teacher did only like that only get answer. Nothing. I took help of battery and this is zero volt. This is a wire, no? This is zero volt. So therefore, this should be 20 volt. Two batteries, I just do. So you can do one thing. So no sir, I'll write it as this is x. This y should be x. There's a common y, no? Potential should be same. This is the common y, zero volt. So you can start from here, 20. So if you write here x, then you should write 20 plus x. Then you write here y. But don't, you should write y. So then if you write y here, this is 20, no? Potential difference should be 20 volt. Then what you should write here, no? Y minus 20. Anything, you try any alternative, you'll get the same answer. Charge of I think only x is unknown, no? See, when you're defining potential, you have to see that the unknown potential should also be minimum. That's why it put, so some students, what they do is like, they'll assume here y. Okay, no, you'll get answer, but you have to write more equations. So then I wanted to minimize the equation, therefore I brought only one unknown x. So even when you define potentials, you should define in such a way that the unknown potential should be minimum. So you can also do one thing. Sir, how come zero? Then you do one thing, write y. Then there should be 20 plus y. 20 plus y. Then there should be how much here? Like a 20 plus y. So and so here you come for this one. This is over. Then this should be some you have to define. You can write 10. You write 0, 0, 0. Solve it. Okay, now only one junction is there. Hit LO junction. Or note. Then 4 into x plus 20 minus 20 plus 4 into x plus 20 minus 0. Then next, this will be 4 into x minus 0. Two into x plus 10 minus 0 equal to 0. Only unknown thing is x, solve for x, you'll get the required answer.
Minus 50 by 7.
Minus 50 by 7.
Minus 50 by 7. Okay, once you get x, it'll be very easy, you know. So even the defining potentials also, you can use some method where the number of unknowns will get minimized here. So I could have defined this zero. If you define this is zero, then this will become some y. Are you getting, no? Number of unknowns will increase. This is the method. So like you do one thing. Say best thing, see, you learn only by what? By experimentation. Same problem. You define this is zero, zero. You call this is y, and you call this is some x. Solve it. You'll get same answer. But you don't get x, this value, some other value. Solve it, but you calculate the charge in any one capacitor, both the answers will be same. If you want to try once, if not getting, you can take my help. You have to find out equivalent capacitance. Already I solved it, huh? This one. Earlier class, did I solve this? Anybody?
No, sir.
No, we didn't solve it. Huh? Okay, now how to find out equivalent capacitance? We have only two options, no? Charge distribution or nodal analysis. We'll connect one cell, we'll define potential. But anyway, all together, see either of method. I'll show both the methods. I'll show first nodal analysis. Let me do it. Find equivalent capacitance C14. First nodal analysis. For nodal analysis, so I'll take the cell of, don't take 1000 volt, 100 volt, greater values. So if you take the larger values, no, lot of calculations will be known, no? Choose some 2 volt, even 2 volt, if you choose, don't choose 2 volt also, because again, fractions will come 2.3, 2.8 exam. That's why choose some 10 volt. That is a nominal, I feel 10 or 6 like that. Don't choose 50, 80, huh? Calculations will be heavy. Okay, this should be 100 volt. This is 0 volt. That's what I defined it. Then I definitely, I don't know, because there are no cell is there, no? So what is the only alternative? This should be V2. This should be V3. V5. So how many unknowns are there? V2, V3, V5, V6. So getting that. We'll get it. So now I'll begin like this. So this should be the, so let's write it at node 2. At a low color node. V2 minus, so everything capacitance, so V2 minus 100 plus V2 minus C into V2 minus V3 equal to 0. So this should be equal to 3V2 plus 100 plus V3 plus V6. Similarly, at blue color node 6, so this should be V6, C into V6 minus 100, C into V6 minus V2, C into four V6 equal to 100 plus V2 plus V3 plus V5. I think by this time everyone getting, there's no concept, no, just by, it's a skill. In gray color node 3, V3 minus V2, V3 minus V6, C into V3 minus V5 plus C into, all set equal 0. So this will become 4V3 plus V2 at node 5. Oh. Ten volt. Okay, it should be 10, I think. I'll change it. Yeah, thank you. It should be 10, everywhere 10. Okay, now red color note. I'll minimize it. Let's write the equation. Red color note where it is. V5. V6 plus C into how many unknowns are there? 2, 3, 5, 6. 4 equations, 4 unknowns. Solving this, we'll get the required answer. Then after getting this, then what is needed? So you can directly jump into the only these two capacitors. So don't bother anything like, once you know V2, V6, calculate the charge in these two. Then that much of charge should be pushed by this. I'll finish off the question. This 10 volt cell here. So here QA charge, QB charge. Only don't go for again distribution. Okay, we got it, no? So then what is the capacitance? So this will be C14, should be equal to QA plus QB by 10. QA, QB, once you know potential V2 and V6, you can calculate QA. So what is QA? 10 minus I'll write it here. No, first QA should be 10 minus V2 into C. What is QB? 10 minus V6 into C. Even for equivalent capacitance also, you can use nodal analysis. That is what my main purpose of what I'm discussing here. Even for equivalent capacitance also, you can bring nodal analysis, not only finding out charge. Now, what is the other alternative? Charge distribution. Let me do that also. It'll give overall picture for you. It's left to you. Which one you feel very convenient, you can pick up. Where we are? Here.
Sir, answer is 7C by 12, sir.
7C by 12.
I'm getting 11, sir.
11, it is coming.
11C by 15, I'm getting.
11C by 15. Same problem, I'll divide the charge. You can see this. We will try charge distribution, how it is possible. So again, I'm going to connect it. If you want, you write 10 volt or say you can write only V. Let me choose 10 volt. So I'm going to divide the charge. So let this be Q1. So here Q3 has come here, no? So Q2 minus Q3 should be here. I'll show only on one plate. It'll take more time. Then finally, what charge should leave? In between, how the charge distribution? Your Q3 charge has come, Q1 plus Q3. So your Q2 minus Q3, I'll bring it here. How much charge here should be? Q1 minus Q2 plus 2 Q3. Q1 minus Q2 plus 2 Q3. Look at this charge. What should be the charge here? Should be Q3. So I'll justify my answer. Q1 minus Q2 plus 2 Q3. That much of charge will come here. Okay, fine. Here from how much will plus Q2 minus Q2. This will cancel. Minus Q3 plus Q3. What will be left over here? Q1 plus Q3. So that Q1 will go here, Q3 will come here. So from here, Q3 will come. Here, Q2 minus Q3. Q3, Q3 get cancelled, so only Q2. How many unknowns are there? Q1, Q2, Q3. So write three loop equations, solve, you'll get the required answer. So you write one loop equation. Three equations we needed. Three unknowns are there, no? Three loop equations are needed. So first one loop equation plus 10. Plus 10 minus Q2 by C. Q1 by C equal to 0. What is the loop? There's a loop. This is the one thing. Then again, we'll take next loop, this one. Minus Q2 by C, minus Q3 by C, plus Q1 by C. The loop is this one. This is the one loop we have took. Next, one more you can write it here or already this we have taken, okay, no? So you write one loop here or else one path here. No, see, solve this. We'll get equivalent capacitance 11C by 15. C, value of C, how much given? 15 farad. 11 farad will come. So I think definitely charge distribution, you should be very alert. That's all. You should be correct. If charge distribution is correct, you'll get answer correct. But nodal analysis, there's no thing. Somehow you define potential. Only thing is what is the take care, what you should take care here? The potential difference across cell. As there is only one cell, so definitely randomly put potentials here because this is zero, this is zero. So define these potentials, right? Charge of a cell should be conserved. Find the charge supplied by the cell after closing the switches. Try to look at this. Will there be any charge in these capacitors? because if this were of different capacitance, charge will come. So I think I'll make the problem. If this were 1 farad, 2 farad, if it were some, so like a, some other value, so 2, 4, 6, 8, definitely you have to put some charge. No charge will be there in these capacitors. So the overall circuit will be so if intentionally examiner wants so that you should not solve the problem, he may ask you a problem. If examiner wants you to learn from question paper, he will ask you some questions of this kind. It, the moment it appears something very big, but no charge will pass through this these capacitors. Okay, there's a parallel. Okay, that one, some series is there. Okay, check the series. 1/1, 1+1/3, effective, the total capacitance, this should be equal to. One by C dash we'll call it. So this will be 1+1. Check the what will be this series. Then total capacitance should be equal to C dash plus C dash. What is this C dash? C dash is this much. This everything is what? C dash. Even this also be C dash. So and they're parallel. So I'm going to add them this one. Answer will be 4 farad. Check that one.
Charge will be 4, sir.
What happened?
C will be 4/3, sir.
E will be 4/3. Charge will be 4, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, it's asking charge, no? let me check the question. I'll find the charge. 4 coulomb. Find the work done by the cell in charging the given capacitors of circuit. He's asking work done by the cell. No. What will be your find the work done by the cell? So what shall we do? Shall we go for distribution of charge method or the nodal analysis? That is what a student has to take a decision here. Like, so already it's a cell, no? Okay, only one cell is there. So little bit. The difficulty in defining potential also will be reduced, no, by very much. So this you can straight away go and write this is 10 volt. Fine. So now how many branches are there? So this is V1, V2, V3, V4. Similarly, what we did earlier, that the same method. Again, division of charge, you see, like definitely we have to take a risk, that one. We should be very particular about division of charge. Nodal analysis doesn't need much effort. So at V1, at node 1, I'll write it. At node 1, it will be C into. In exam, no need to write C also, no? That will be V1 minus 10, C and will get canceled out. This will be C into V1 minus V2 C into V1 3V1 is equal to 10 plus V2 plus V3. At node 2, V2 minus 10, I think 4 capacitors will come there. C into V2 we are taking out now, V1 plus V3 plus V4. At node 3, C into V3 minus V1, C into V3 minus V2. This, I think now it has some general method, no? Any student can really work out this. It's there's no any difficulty. Solving this will get the required answer.
73.33
capacitance work done by
sir. Sorry, heat generated.
Actually, half of it will go as heat, no?
Sir, half of it will be.
Half of the work done will be.
Yes, sir.
Work done. Okay, work done by
46.6.
Yeah, okay. I'll write down. Work done by cell. After this, so what actually you got it? You got the potentials. Again, what is the method? Say the problem is not at all. Okay, don't say you got potential. So that again, just check only the charges. Charge entered, because what all charge enters will here only. So that is what you calculate these two charges. The charge should be pushed by this cell. The next part of the problem is. Okay. Let's continue the question here. You need not to do anything. Just assume anything. So I think we assume what potential V1, no? V1, V2. Yeah, fine. Okay, here you assume Q1 minus Q1 minus Q2. So what is this? This we define 10 volt. This is V1,
sir.
V2. Yeah. Let me finish. Let me finish off. So Q1 is equal to 10 C into okay, then what is the work done by the cell? Okay. Yeah, somebody was asking doubt.
Sir, the above one and this one both are same, no, sir?
Circuit, huh?
Yes, sir, both are same, sir.
This sir, one, huh?
Same.
Okay, yeah, fine, I didn't notice. Shape only changed, huh? Yeah, let it be. I didn't notice, sir. Only that shape they have changed it, no? Yeah, anyway, so got the method, no? This is what then heat generated will be off of this one, heat generated. Okay, tomorrow we'll continue from here. Huh? So tomorrow we'll go for dialytic slab, some related problems there. Okay, thank you, all of you. Yeah.
Can you send that online class notes, sir?
All their individual files, no, again, combining them. Which one you want?
Only dialectic, sir.
Only dialectic. Okay, fine. I'll upload that one.
Okay, sir. Thank you.